Hi, my name is Shanaz. We'll start this lecture with the definition of exact sequences. So basically, an exact sequence is actually a sequence of R modules and R module homomorphisms. So a sequence of R modules, where this R is a commutator ring with unity, and R homomorphisms. Of type, so we'll start this by this module M naught, and then we have this arrow. Now this arrow represents an R module, and let us R module homomorphism. Let us know this module homomorphism by phi naught. So this goes to M1, and from M1 we have a morphism, module homomorphism phi 1, which goes into phi M2, so on. This goes to, suppose here we have Mn, and this Mn goes to Mn plus 1, and this is the map Pn. So these Mi's, they are R modules, and these phi I's, they are R module homomorphism. So this sequence is said to be exact, is called exact if image of preceding module homomorphism is actually, I mean, if, so suppose we have here phi n minus 1. So if image of phi I is equal to kernel of phi I plus 1. So this is phi 1 here, this is phi 2 here. If image of p 1 is same as kernel of phi 2, so we are, we say that the sequence is exact sequence. So here we have this mi plus 1, and this is phi I plus 1, and this is phi I, this is mi. Now one can note here phi I, image of phi I is actually a subgroup of, a submodule of M. So image of phi I sits here, and similarly kernel of phi I plus 1 also sits here. So this makes sense. So this makes sense here. So when we are having this equality, we say the sequence is this sequence is an exact sequence. Now a short exact sequence, this is an so let M, M prime, M and M double prime, so these are R modules, B R modules. Then the exact sequence of the type, so 0 goes to M prime, M prime, from M prime we have a module homomorphism to M, and from M we have a modulo homomorphic to M double prime, and this from this we have a map which goes to 0. So if I take phi here and g here, so if this is an exact sequence, then this type of sequence is called a short exact sequence. Is called a short is called a short exact sequence. Now we have just written here 0. Now by 0 I mean actually a sub module generated by 0, which is actually the 0 module, and similarly this is the 0 module. So we don't keep these braces here. So by 0 here we mean a 0 sub module of a 0 module. Now for this sequence to be exact, one can note here this map is actually the inclusion map, so it takes 0 to 0. Since M prime is an R module, so 0 is there, so this I this takes 0 to 0. Finally, for this homomorphism is actually the 0 homomorphism, so this is actually multiplication by 0. So what it does, it takes all elements of M double prime to 0. So 0 morphism is actually 0 modulo homomorphism. This multiplication by 0 is actually an R module homomorphism. Now what do we mean by this sequence to be exact? So by definition, image of I should be the kernel of phi. So let us make this remark here. So since star is exact, we have, so image of I is kernel of f, but image of I is just singleton, i.e. kernel of f is image of I, which is 0. Now since, so if kernel of f is singleton, that means f is injective. Now for this sequence to be exact here, we get the injectivity of f. Now if we look at the exactness over this module, we get surjectivity of g. Hence f is injective. Now for this sequence to be exact at M double prime, we have also image of G is kernel of this multiplication map. So let us draw this map by M, kernel of M. So image of G is kernel of M. Now since this M takes all M double prime to 0, so it is kernel is whole M double prime, since every element in M double prime goes to 0. So if we have M double prime here, this goes to 0. So this is true for every element in M double prime. So this image of G is kernel of M, which is actually equal to whole M double prime. Now that means this G is surjective, because image of G is M double prime, i.e. this image of this map here is M double prime, that means G is surjective. Hence G is surjective. Therefore, for this sequence here, where this is 0 goes into M prime, M prime goes into M, and M goes into M double prime, and M double prime goes to 0. So we have map F here, we have G here. So if this is an exact sequence, then this F is injective and this G is surjective. Now let us give some examples of short exact sequences. So this is an example. So let us take over. So now let us consider the Z modules. So let over M prime be 2Z. Obviously, this is an Z module. I mean 2Z is actually a Z module, where Z is the ring of integers. Let's take M to be the Z. So here M is, so this Z is modulo over itself, and M double prime, let us take this module to be Z mod 2Z. So all M prime, M and M double prime, they are Z modules. Now let us look at this sequence. So we have 0 goes into 2Z. This is the natural inclusion map. This 2Z goes to Z. This is again inclusion map. Now from Z to 2Z, we had a natural canonical map, i.e. the projection map. So this is Z here, this is 2Z here. So this is the projection map pi. Now what it does, it takes A and this, it maps A to A bar, i.e. A plus 2Z. Now to prove this is exact, we have to prove image of I is same as kernel of pi. So we have image of I is actually, now image of I here, I is the inclusion map. So it takes 2Z here to the to the copy of 2Z which is already lying in Z. So this is actually 2Z. And now so we have pi from Z to Z mod 2Z. Now it maps an element A to A plus 2Z. Obviously, if A is odd, we have a non-trivial if. So if we look the identity element here, the zero element here, so it contains the cosets of 2Z. So it has actually two elements, one is 0 bar and other is 1 bar. Now by 0 bar we mean 0 plus Z, that is Z, and 1 bar we mean 1 plus Z. So these are the only two elements here. Now the kernel of this projection map phi is so kernel of phi is all those A in Z whose image under pi is 0 here. Now 0 by 0 we mean, sorry, this is 2Z here, we mean 2Z here, that is all those elements is in Z such that pi of A, which is actually A plus 2Z, is 2Z. Now we have a basic property of coset, that is A plus H is H if and only if A is in H. So A plus 2z is 2z if and only if A is 2z. That means all those elements in all those integers which are even, i.e. which are in 2z. So that is a set of even integers. So this is 2z. So image of I is, kernel of I, pi is 2z, and same is image of I, which is again 2z. So this is an exact sequence. So if we mark this sequence here by, so this is 0 here, I have forgot to write down the 0 here. So if I mark this sequence here by this symbol, so since image of I is kernel of pi, this hash is exact, I mean short exact sequence, as exact as this is short exact sequence. Let us do one more example. So let us consider two R modules. So this is example two. So let M1 and M2 be two R modules. Let M be their direct sum. Then the sequence zero goes to M1, M1 goes to M, M goes to M2. This is actually, this is a short exact sequence. Now since M is a direct sum of M1 plus M2, this means this M is also isomorphic to M1 cross M2, their direct product. Now let us denote this map by F and this map by G. Now let us look at the image of F. We have to prove image of F is equal to kernel of G. So this is exact sequence. Since image of F, so image of F, now first we have to define this map. Now it takes an element, say M1 in M1, and it maps this M1 to an element in M. Now M being isomorphic to M1 cross M2, so we can express every element of M as an ordered pair M1 or we can so this M1 cross M2 has elements of the form say M1 M2 where this M1 is in M1 and M2 is in M2. Write down this subscript M1 M2. So we have to define a map from M1 to M, which is actually isomorphic to M1 cross M2. So we take an element M1 and we carry out this M1 to this order pair M1 comma 0. So if we define F like that, so this F is a well-defined homomorphism. So therefore, image of F will be M1 comma 0, such that this M1 is in M1. Now for kernel, now we have to define a map G from M to M2. So this G will be a projection of M onto M2. So this, we now we have to define a map, say G from M to M2. Now this M being isomorphic to M1 cross M2, so this map is defined as, so it takes an order pair, an element here, say M1 comma M2, it maps this element to an element of M2. So this is just M2. So this is actually projection of M on M2. So it annihilates, it kills the first component here. So this therefore this kernel of G will be all those elements in M, such that G of M1 M2 is 0. That is all those odd pairs in M, such that now G of M1 M2 is what? This is just M2. So this has to be 0. It means that the kernel of G contains all those odd pairs whose second component is 0. So kernel of G will be M1 0, such that this M1 is in M1. Now if we look at this image of F, and this kernel of G, they are equal, they are same. So hence kernel of G is same as image of F. Therefore this sequence, so let us mark this sequence by dollar sign. So hence, therefore, the sequence in dollar is a short exact sequence. Now let us define what do we mean by a simplet exact sequence, a simplet exact sequence. So let us define this. So if we have a short exact sequence, so if 0 goes to M prime, M prime goes to M, and M goes to M double prime. So we have a map F here and a map G here, and M double prime goes to 0. So if this be a short exact sequence, then this exact sequence is said to be a split exact sequence. If there exists an R module homomorphism H from M double prime to M, such that, so we have this homomorphism here, such that if we compose this G with H, this is now G H will be a map. So first we have H, we have to apply H. So H is a morphism from M double prime, and this is a homomorphism from M double prime to M. Then we have to take this map G, which is a map from M to M double prime. So if we take this composition G composed with H, this will be a homomorphism from M double prime to M double prime. So this GH is a map from M double prime to M double prime. So if this happens to be the identity on M double prime, then we call this sequence to be the split exact sequence. So this is the condition. So this exact sequence is said to be a split exact sequence if there exists a map H from M double prime to M, such that this composite map is identity on M double prime. So in that case, this H is said to be, in this H is called the splitting. So note the map H from M double prime to M is called the splitting.